السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh.
Lesson number 891. This lesson has got to do with standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being accountable for our deeds. Hazrat Ali ibn Hatib radiyallahu anhu says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, on the day of Qiyamah, a person will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no intermediary between the two. When a person will look at his right hand side, he'll only see his actions. When a person will look at his left hand side, he'll only see his actions. He will look around him, there will be nobody else. It will be only him standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person will look in front of him, he will only see the fire, and he will see the burning fire of Jahannam. Thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, O people, save yourself from this fire, even if it be with a mere dry date. This hadith is made mention of in Bukhari Sharif. In this year we learn that if it means a person has to do a little, even if it is a date which has dried up, if it is something which is minimal, then to send it, spend it in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so at least that we will be saved by virtue of the good that we do from this tormentful fire. Also, try and give 2 rands, 2 pounds, 2 rupees, 2 dollars, 2 euros, 2 bananas, 2 pears, a set of 2 of anything immediately out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is charity. Be to a poor person, be to a needy, be to the domestic that is helping you in the house, the nearest person that is deserving, give 2 of that out in the path of Allah. The meaning of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that that person who gives 2, a couple of things, he gives a pair of things in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then on the day of Qiyamah, such a person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will give him the option of going into any path of Jannah as he pleases. From Quran and Hadith, wherever we learn and we see about the fire and its torment, its punishment, its description, it is meant for us to do those deeds that will save us from it and grant us entry into Jannah. It is there for us to take lesson. We must not commit those deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry with us and puts us into the fire. Let us now make dua. O Allah, save us from the tormentful fire of Jahannam. O Allah, save us from the fire of Jahannam. O Allah, save us from the fire of Jahannam. Whoever will make this dua, Jahannam will tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not bring such a person close to me. And we also make dua, O Allah, grant us Jannatul Firdaus. O Allah, grant us Jannatul Firdaus. O Allah, grant us Jannatul Firdaus. By doing this, Jannah takes your name. And he says, O Allah, grant so and so person entry into me. And the third thing for today's sabak, the first thing we're doing is, we're giving charity of any pair of things. Be it money, be it some sort of kind thing, anything that we can, immediately try and give it out. The second is we're making dua to be saved from the fire and entry into Jannah. And the third thing is we read, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل Shay'in Qadir. We have read this. Now the heavens have opened for us. And Allah is waiting, what will we ask? We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us Jannatul Firdaus in the neighborhood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ameen. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.